welcome to Femme Parler Podcast, where we are unpacking opinions and changing destinations. I am your host, Shirley Altidore, where each week we will chat about how to rise strong out of all types of obstacles that come with relationships. Through personal life experiences and discussions ranging from infidelity, trust, forgiveness, sex, heartbreak, self-love, and so much more, I am passionate and obsessed to provide guidance to every woman to create a better life. Let's dive in, pull up a seat, make sure you're cozy, and get ready to be challenged and encouraged while you learn. With me, your virtual girlfriend. Welcome back to Femme Parler Podcast. Today we're going to be talking about, what does marriage mean? Has your point of view changed about marriage over the years? Do you think that marriage is a legal trap? Are you single and thinking of marriage differently? Do you feel that marriage is the right Christian thing to do? Are you unsure if marriage is something that is really what you want? On today's episode, we're going to speak with our guest and see her viewpoint about marriage. So, to introduce our special guest today, we have my dearest friend who's been my friend for over 10 years, who gets on my nerves every chance that she gets. We have Queen Lakeshia, who is joining us today. Just some insights on her. She does have her bachelor's in information system technology. So, Keisha, why don't you introduce yourself to our listeners?
Hey, everybody. I'm Keisha, Lakeshia, or whatever you want to call me. But yes, I've known Shirley for a very long time, and I'm ready to talk about marriage and what it means to me.
Wonderful, wonderful. So our first question is, how do you identify yourself? Are you single? Are you in a complicated relationship? Or what are you?
Such a hard question. It shouldn't be this hard. But I am going to say, as of today or as of whenever, I'll say it's complicated. So a complicated relationship.
Okay. All right. Complicated relationship. Do you want to share with us, what do you mean by complicated?
We're together sometimes. Sometimes we're not together. It just depends. There's a lot of attitudes going on, and I don't know. What do you want to know about it?
Well, I mean, what do our listeners want to hear about it from your point of view? So I guess the first question we're going to ask you is, how do you feel about marriage now? Do you want to share your age?
I am 43.
So from a 43-year-old point of view, who's been in a relationship for quite some time, how do you feel about marriage? Especially speaking to our younger ones who are in their 20s, 18, 19, 20, under 30, who are like, oh my God, marriage, I need my husband.
Well, I do believe in marriage, and I do believe that there is someone for everyone, because it's in the Bible. So I think we all should be married at some point in life. As it stands for me, do I believe in marriage? I do believe in marriage, and I always did. Like, when I was a little girl, I was like, oh, I'm going to get married. I'm going to have two kids. We're going to have that whole white picket fence type thing going on. But now that I'm older, marriage has changed a bit for me. I don't see it as I used to see it, because now, being that I'm a mature woman, I feel like I've done everything for myself. I'm a professional, and I don't need a man. I don't know how I'm going to say this, but I don't need anybody to validate who I am. So because I have such a strong personality and I'm just such a strong woman, I need the man that I marry to be just as strong.
Okay, so to piggyback off, you said you made a comment of everyone should be married. Why do you feel as though everyone should be married?
It's in the Bible.
So you look at marriage from a Christian point of view or from a legal point of view?
Well, I I haven't done everything the Christian way. But I do believe in God. I am a Christian. And if I could change the way that I did things when I was younger, I would.
Do you think it would have made a difference when it came to marriage? If you had made some different choices, rather with your men or with what?
I do. Think that it would have made a difference. I wish I would have followed the Bible more closely. I mean, I have kids now out of wedlock, two different fathers. I just think if I did things differently and I based it on the teachings of the Bible, then I would be in a different place right now.
Being that both of us, I would say, are alpha females, and you as my friend, I know you pretty well, and I do understand what you mean, that you do everything, like you handle your business. You're like very independent, and you are a prime example of a woman where you want a man, but you don't need a man. So I'll give you an example. When I was a little girl, I knew that I always wanted to have children, and I was raised up in the church. My grandfather is a pastor. We went to church every Sunday faithfully. I mean, the Bible was literally like, this is life. This is it. You don't need to know anything else but the Bible. But even as a little girl, I knew regardless if I was married or not, I always knew I wanted children. Regardless if a man felt as though I was worthy enough to be his wife, I was going to have kids. Now, by me sharing that with you, is that how you saw things? Like, how did you end up having children? Is it something you wanted? Is it something that just happened? Because, like you said, you wish you would have made different choices. So you would have waited to have your children before you were married, or?
Yeah, I would have waited to have my children after I was married. I did not think like you.
Okay.
I didn't think, oh, I'm going to have two children. Like, it was always, I'm going to have a husband. I didn't know who my husband was going to be, how he was going to be. But I knew before I had babies, I would be married.
Do you feel marriage is necessary? And I guess in your first question that I asked when you were explaining yourself, you said everyone should be married, which is interesting to me because how do you feel for women who are not married? Or let's speak about me as your friend who's been in a relationship for over, I think we're entering 23 years. Old heads, who's in a serious relationship, who's not married, since you said you feel everyone should be married.
Okay. No judgment. But I was basing it on the Bible. Like, maybe I should change that and say, it's whatever you want. We're all individuals, so we all know what we want. We all know what we need. I still want marriage.
Okay.
Marriage is something that I still want, but I need to find a man. And I know I said I'm in a relationship, but I need to be in a relationship and get married to a guy who will compliment me, who will be a partner with me.
I totally understand. So you don't see yourself being married with the person that you're with presently?
It's possible. We have some work that we need to do in order to move forward, but it is possible. Anything's possible.
And if you don't mind me asking, how long have you guys been in a relationship?
After a while, I just started counting, but I know it's been at least 10 years.
So it's been 10 plus.
Yes. Yes.
And even at this point, you feel as though there are still things you're working on?
Yes. Yes. We're working on communication. We're working on ourselves, and we're working on just how to get along with each other, because, you know, as you get older, you change. Mm-hmm. Like, you may not be the same person that you were when you first met that person. So we're constantly evolving. We're constantly have to learn each other more.
So why should people get married? Should people get married for a legal reason or for Christian reasons? And it seems as though from Keisha's point of view, marriage to you, you look at it from a Christian standpoint, strictly.
Well, I think if you want to get married, you need to get married for the right reasons. And to me, the right reason would be because you're in love with that person and you feel like that's the only one for you. So I can't say for Christian reasons or what was the other?
Legal.
No, I definitely don't think legal reasons. And if you're in love with someone, marry them if that's what you want to do. And maybe I'm going all around here, but.
No, it's okay. So let's say you have someone who wants to get married. Marriage is important to them, but they're not looking at it from a Christian standpoint. Or let me phrase it this way. Let's say you have someone that is been with somebody for some time, rather it be a short time or a long time, and they're very interested in being together, but marriage is something that they both frown upon, that they don't feel as though legally they need to let the state that they're in know that they're together, because it is very possible to have a fruitful life without being legally married by the state if you have all your paperwork set up properly. It's very, very possible. Prime example, Khalif and I bought a house and we weren't married, but we both have a tie to that house. And if something was to happen, the split is 50-50, you know, and there are wills and things you can set up in place where you can have your partner be responsible for your finances. You can set things up properly where no one would probably even know if you were married or not if you didn't decide to share with the general public. So do you feel as though that's a wrong thing if two people were to mutually agree upon being together, but they don't want to get married, but they set up all their paperwork up properly, bank accounts, wills, and have everything in order of how it should be, where if something was to happen to them, their partner would be able to have access to their money, be the power of attorney to make decisions if something happens. How do you feel about that?
I think that can make situations very complicated. Like, say you guys were splitting, and I know you said that you have all the paperwork in order, but what if it's a couple that doesn't have all that paperwork together, mm-hmm. and they just decide, okay, we're not going to be together anymore. We got this house. Like, it can become a very bad situation. So I don't agree with that. But again, it's not about me. Like, that's not about me, because that's not what I'm doing. But I do respect other people who choose to go that route.
So you said you don't agree with that route. Which for I myself. Get for yourself, I mm-hmm. get you. But to give some insight on some others' viewpoints, that route that I explained to you is not much different than someone having a divorce if they were separated. That even gets just as complicated and sticky.
Okay, well, speaking of divorce, I think when I'm married, and I've always said this since I was a little girl, I am not getting a divorce. I'm going to do it once, and I'm going to make sure that it works. I don't know how I can make sure it works, but I don't want to have to go through a divorce with anybody, because I see how it breaks up families and how it destroys people. So that's why I'm so careful about marriage, and I'm so specific about what I want in a marriage. Like, me and my husband have to be very compatible. We have to be able to communicate with each other. We just have to be each other's best friends. If you're not my best friend, if we can't communicate, then our marriage isn't going to work. It's possible that we could end up in a divorce. So I want to make sure all of this is right before I jump into a marriage with someone.
It's interesting that you say that. You want to make sure everything is right before you jump into a marriage with someone. But you do know every 7 years, there's like a rebirth cycle. Even when we become like adults, how can I explain? Like, every 7 years, I feel like it's a change, and I'm explaining this completely wrong, but even a relationship, every 7 years, there's like a rebirth to your relationship. So let's say when you guys been married, let's say you have been married for a long time, and now you two are two completely different people than you were 20 years ago. Mm-hmm. And this is what I realize the world, society has done. We like to put just negative connotations on everything. We've put such negativity on divorce that even if someone wanted to have a divorce, they're fearful of what people are going to think, or they allow themselves to be in situations that they may not be 100% happy with, but they don't want to be seen as a failure by the world. So they're not going to have a divorce because, oh my gosh, my family or my friends are going to think I'm a failure. So I'm not going to do this. I stayed in this, you know, because till death do us part, and I'm going to do everything I have to make it work. But just because two people, in my opinion, from Shirley's point of view, do decide to go separate routes, or life has changed, you may not feel for your partner how you used to, and that's just reality because we're all human. You see that as not something you would do. Or I guess the question I should ask you, why do you feel so negatively about having a divorce? Do you feel as though it's you're a how do you feel? Do you feel as though you're going to be seen as a failure, or because of a Christian viewpoint that you strongly feel that's not something you should do?
I've never really cared how other people view me, but it's just something that I've always thought about. And I mean, I do see in the Bible that it says there shouldn't be any divorce. And I'm not, like I said, I'm not the most godly person. I do believe in God. I go to church on a regular basis, but I try to live by the word. I do try to live by the word. And of course, I kind of messed up a bit, but I'm getting better. It's just, I don't want to have to go through having a divorce. It puts people through a lot mentally, physically. And I'm an older woman. I feel like I'm an older woman. And it also makes you think, like, how many other men out here are for me at this age? There's so many younger girls. So most men probably prefer younger women. And even if they're like a 50-year-old man, if they could get like a 30-year-old woman instead, they'd probably rather have a 30-year-old woman than a 50-year-old woman or a woman their age. I don't know. But I'm not trying to go through this again. I just want it to be one time I get married, and that's that. Me and my husband will need to agree, or my future husband will need to agree, that we're going to work out whatever difficulties we come across. Whatever happens in a relationship, we have to be open to getting help. If we need to go to counseling, if we need to do whatever, we just need to do that to make our relationship work. And he has to want it as much as me. And I mean, I can't guarantee that we'll have like the perfect relationship, because nobody has the perfect relationship. But going into the marriage, I want him to know that this is what I want. And if he doesn't want that, then I don't think we should be together.
So with that mindset, why do you even wait to get married? You might as well just marry him within like 6 months of meeting him, because you might as well just get together.
Well, we need to make sure that we're compatible. So that takes time. And like I said, with the person that I'm with now, we're working on things. So we can't just say, okay, we're going to jump the broom. Like, we have to iron out the kinks in the relationship and agree on some things in order for us to move forward.
But what if you were to iron out the kinks and the wrinkles come back? What difference does it make if, I'll give you a prime example. First 5 years into relationship, everything's all nice and smooth, working things nicely. Y'all get married. But 10 years into the relationship, you got some heavy wrinkles you got to deal with. And let's say y'all wasn't married. What difference would it make?
See, you know what? One thing I would have changed from the beginning, being with somebody for 10 years and not being married. Because, you know, you hear people saying, oh, I'm not going to be with nobody for 5 years and they asked to marry me and this and that. And I mean, I'm not sure I had it planned that we would be together for all these years and not be married. I'm not even sure if marriage is what I was looking for when we first got together. It kind of evolved into that, like, okay, so we've been together this long, because, you know, sometimes you feel like, okay, we've been together all this time, so we should just get married. It don't always work like that, because as the years go up, as the years increase, you're like, oh, I don't like that about him, or, oh, I don't like that about her. And you're just like, ooh. So it changes things. But, you know, one of my aunts told me, things like, don't wait 2 and 3 years to get married. Y'all get married right away. So I'm thinking, like, if you get married so soon, then later on you'll find things that you don't like about the person because you didn't take enough time to get to know that person. But as the years go on, you really get to see the person's true colors, because usually in a relationship, the first year or maybe the first couple months or whatever are like the best time. Like, y'all having a good time, y'all going out, y'all doing things, the communication is good. And then as it builds up, that's when you start to see a lot of things that you don't like. And I guess that's when you start to change. Like, I never heard about that 7-year evolve thing in a relationship. But I know people are constantly changing. And if that person isn't able to accept you for who you are, then how can the relationship work? So that's why I think you should really, you should take your time, but you shouldn't wait like 10 and 20 years before you get married to somebody. And I don't even know how to put it, but that's a long time.
I mean,
because you can find so much stuff wrong with the person.
Yeah. And that's why I was going to ask you, because you have your friend sitting right here who's been in a relationship for over 20 years, who's not married. The reason I wanted to bring it up to you is because, of course, most people probably don't have my little warp thinking, because although marriage was important to me, it wasn't something that was a top priority to me. Mm-hmm. I knew I wanted children. And I think one of the reasons solely behind that is because I have an aunt who does not have children because she was not married. And as a little girl, because I saw her pain, I realized to myself, like, I asked her one day, so you're waiting for a man to marry you to have children? That's one of the reasons that my thinking changed, because I knew as a little girl, I wanted kids. So why do I have to wait for someone to think, okay, your wife potential, now we can start a family? If I want a family, I want that to be my choice. I can have my own little family. Mm-hmm. But I'm also one of those women that also feel as though I strongly believe in, like, single women who are very well to do, have good jobs. I totally agree 100% if they wanted to go have children on their own and do the whole pregnancy thing on their own. So that's why I feel the way I feel about marriage, because I saw the pain that my aunt went through, because you're waiting on a marriage so you can have children.
But is that true? Was she waiting on a marriage?
She was not going to have children until she was married.
Okay. Okay. But because there's other ways to have children. And I do see single women having children all the time, whether it's adoption or they might go to a sperm bank or anything. Like, you can still have children.
She wanted a husband.
Okay.
Because this is what society, I shouldn't even say society. I think it's more of a Christian thing. She wanted a husband to have children. So that's the reason why she didn't have children, because she didn't have a husband. So of course, her niece didn't have that thinking, because I was having children regardless. I was having children. It had nothing to do with marriage for me. I wanted children. So I made a decision to have children with a man that we had already spoke about our future. So we knew we were going to be together. So even though we're not married, we knew what we were getting into. So we mutually agreed when it came time to have our children. It wasn't just I was trapping him, or I was like, okay, well, you're going to give me kids regardless what you think. It was a discussion we had. So it was communicated.
I have a question for you. So say, I guess you guys were boyfriend and girlfriend at the time. So say, did you have a age put on when you wanted to have your first child?
Before I was 30.
Before you was 30. You just knew before you was 30. Okay, so say you were 30 and you weren't in a relationship.
I most likely would have gone to the sperm bank or did it my way.
Okay.
Yep.
Okay, but would an option be just to find any man, not any man, but maybe
I know what you
ask
mean.
A friend or somebody to have one with you?
I don't think I thought about it at that time. Mm-hmm. I think the first thing I thought about is going to a sperm bank.
Hmm. Okay.
So it's something that I had in my mind that, you know, if I don't have children by the time I'm 30, I will figure it out myself. I just knew it wasn't that marriage wasn't important to me. So I don't want people to think that I completely disregard marriage. it just wasn't at the top of my priority list. Mm-hmm. You know, the top of my priority list was make sure I'm okay, have children, and marriage will come after. Where in my order, we had children, we bought a house, and yet we're still not married.
So how do you feel about marriage? What do you think about marriage, being that you've been in this situation?
Oh, I have. So how I see marriage now, my viewpoint about marriage hasn't changed. So I think in my situation, there's so many convoluted layers of why Khalif and I are not married. I think if we, when we were younger, much younger, when we first got together before the kids, at the time when we were younger, Khalif and I didn't want to go to the Justice of Peace. We wanted to actually have a marriage. But understand, we got together, we bought a house, and you have two young people that are flat broke. So the only option we had was to go to the Justice of Peace, and we didn't want to go that route. So to be honest with you, in the beginning, we didn't have money to get married, to plan a whole big wedding and to spend all that money on a place and do all this. And I think between so many different things going on with our lives, us being young, you know, there was a point in time where Khalif wasn't home. You know, he was gone for, I think, like 18 months. And then when he came home, we were still strapped with money. So I think in the beginning with us, it was more financial of why we didn't get married. It's not that we didn't want to get married. It was more financial. And then what I realized with my partner over the years, his mindset slightly changed, where he still feels strongly about marriage, but then he started to have conversations, like legal conversations with me, like, well, why is it important for the state that we're in to legally know that we're married? We've, you know, since we've been together all these times. So that's where his mindset was changing. It's not that he's against it, but his mindset was changing where, why does it have to be such a legal thing? So that already made me think, okay, all right. I don't disagree with him because I already know as a woman how I felt about marriage. So I respect his viewpoint. But I think with Khalif too, the communication sometimes get cuts off and how he communicates with me. Where me, I'm like, I'll communicate as soon as I think of something because I'm sharing my life with this person. So it's important that if my thought process or my feeling changes about something, I have to bring it to their attention because then I'm robbing them of their opinion if I don't tell them how I feel. So when I found this out, at the time I found it out, it was right around the time where we were going through our crisis. Mm-hmm. So I linked the two together and I said, okay, so is it this situation that you're in right now that makes you feel so differently about marriage? So I feel like with that trauma that I was going through and him saying that to me, I was upset about it, but it didn't, I think I was upset about it for the wrong reasons. If I was approached sooner when he immediately thought about it, I could have, we would have went about it differently. Right. Now, recently we had a conversation about marriage and we both still feel strongly about marriage. I can honestly tell you, Khalif and I, we're probably in this for life. I do believe one day we will get married, Keisha.
Okay, because that was going to be one of my questions. Okay,
we will get married one day, but I can't put a date on it quite yet. And I do believe one of the reasons why we're not married is because of the way that I am. Although marriage is important to me, it's never been on the top of my priority list. So I've been doing so many other things and handling so many other things where it's like, okay, we'll just put it on the back burner. We'll wait. We'll do this. This is more important. We can't do this. This is important because also I know what's happening with the finances. I know what's happening with the finances. So I know what we have to work with, what we don't have to work with. And when I have to make financial decisions, it's like, we can't do this because we got to do this. We can't do this because we got to do this. Even now, from how I thought 20 years ago to now, Keisha, I do not want to have a big wedding. And I'm not going to put it over the air of exactly what I want because I'm full of surprises under my sleeve. So, you know, when I get married, you'll probably just hear me blast the post on social media. Well, my close friends won't know that. You know, close friends and family won't know that. But I'm talking about I'll probably just boom, post a picture of us in our, you know, in our marriage outfits. But I am not having a big wedding. Okay. But 20 years ago, oh, I wanted to invite this person and that person and this friend and this person we just ran into yesterday. Now, you'll be lucky if 20 people, let's just put it this way, is at my wedding.
Yeah. And you know what? I'm kind of the same way, because before, like, me and the person I'm with, we were engaged. I don't know if we're still engaged. I mean, I have a complicated relationship and I don't know what's going on from day to day. And that's where communication comes in. And I don't feel like right now we're at the point of communication where we could withstand a marriage. So that's what we're working on. We need to get that together. But we were engaged. He proposed. We were on this private island in the Bahamas and family was there and everything. Now, before, I wanted a big, well, not really a big wedding, but I wanted a wedding out of the country, a destination wedding. And it was only going to be a few people. It's always a few people. And he's more flashy. So I was like, okay, so we can have a reception when we come back to the States. And you can invite whoever you want to invite. And that'll be that. Now, I'm not the kind of person who has a lot of friends. And I do have family, but I'm not really in touch with my family like that. So it would just be my close-knit little circle that would come, maybe like about 20 people or so. And then as I got older, I was like, you know what? I don't need to do all of that, because what am I doing all this for? Am I doing this just to show people? Like, the money that you spend on those things, you can spend on other things.
Yep.
Like pay off a house, pay off a car, pay off student loans, whatever. So I was like, you know what? I just want to go to the Justice of the Peace and get it done with. That's it. But I've noticed when you're younger, you think differently.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you have a more mature mindset when you get older and you're like, you know what? It's so much more I could do with that money. We don't, some people don't even know if those marriages are going to last. Like, I look at people's wedding pictures and then they had a wedding and say they had a wedding in 2003. They're divorced in 2006. You spent all that money and yeah. Now you're not even together. Like,
but you know, that's something you, it's interesting you say that, because when people get married and then within 3 years they divorce, it's interesting for me to hear, was the change that bad that you guys couldn't stay together?
Mm-hmm.
You know, and unless I speak to someone who literally, you know, I do have a guest that's going to come on that I think she was married for within 20 years, but that'd be in a future podcast. But I respect what you're saying. I don't frown upon divorce, but if it's needed, I think it should be done.
Mm-hmm.
It's sad when someone does get married within 5 years, they're separating from each other.
Yeah.
To me, it's so heartbreaking, because it's, what is it that can't be worked out? Mm-hmm. Especially if you speak to someone that had been with somebody 10, 15 years.
Mm-hmm.
And then all of a sudden now you guys get married. And then after the marriage now, how bad did it get that you're breaking up within 5 years or you're divorcing within five
right.
years? You know, but I think it's because the world has put this negativity around divorce and make it seem as though divorce is so bad. I think we as humans, we just complicate every aspect of our life. If divorce is necessary, then it needs to be done. It's sad when two people have to go their separate ways like that, but it's also sad when two people are boyfriend and girlfriend and they break up.
Mm-hmm.
To me, I feel that that's sad. But you got to feel around. There's so many people in this world that it's very possible that at times your compatibility with that individual change. You know, the 20-year-old Shirley is not the same Shirley that she's growing up to be now that I'm less than 3 years away from being 40.
Mm-hmm.
So my mindset is so different. My partner may be growing like I'm growing.
I'm sorry.
Go ahead.
Let me just ask you this. If you would have gotten married to your partner when you were 23, where do you think your relationship would be today? Do you think that you would be in a good space? What do you think about that?
So you're asking me be in a good space. So you, as my close friend, you already know the span of pretty much what, going back 10 plus years. Of all the things that we've been through.
Mm-hmm.
I will say this. One of the many reasons why Khalif and I are still together at this point in the game, I will credit him. I will give the credit to him. he is one of the main reasons why we're still together, because he knows this is where he wants to be. He acknowledges the mistakes that he's made. And there are times where I've presented to him that I said, you know, Khalif, do you think we're still compatible? Do you think this is working between us? Do you feel as though we're getting along? And he's one of the main reasons why we're still together. I have to give him credit. If it was for Shirley, I think within the last few years, I don't know if we would have been together.
So if you were married, do you think you would be considering divorce based on everything that's gone on with
you? Oh, definitely. It's something I would have considered, but I'm also the same individual that I don't see a negativity in it.
Mm-hmm.
So there are other people that would not do it at all. Like, I can speak for my parents. Because of the strong Christians that they are, they're not going to do it. They're not going to do it. And yes, I am a Christian. Yes, I do believe in God. Can I sit here and really, truly be dictating scripture and saying this verse said this, this verse said that? No, I have not properly educated myself in the Bible. I'm going off of my childhood, what was taught to me, and what I've heard over the years, of course, and also how I see things.
Mm-hmm.
I believe if divorce is necessary, it is okay to happen.
Mm-hmm.
But Christians don't see that.
Well, that's not true. All Christians don't feel that way.
Well, yes, yes. So I'm going to say some.
Yeah, some Christians. Like, if they're really into it and they've been following the scriptures and everything, then maybe they don't feel that same way. But
and I guess, too, it's all about perception,
mm-hmm.
about how you're reading the Bible. Because we can read one verse and completely see the verse differently that we're reading.
Right.
And that a lot goes to say with being submissive to your husband. Now, when you use the word submissive, and I'm using this as an example, I know we're straying a little bit, but I want to give that an example when it says perspective. Even me as an alpha female, I have no problem submitting to my husband. But one thing I told Khalif is, as long as you're leading us on that right road, I'm going to be submissive. As soon as I see my husband start to stray or things are not looking right, it is only my obligation as your queen for me to step in.
Mm-hmm.
But a lot of women look at that submissive thing and that I'm not going to submit to no daggone body.
And let me tell you, not I'm gonna looking happen at you here. When you say that word submissive,
yeah.
I was like, I just cringe. I can't.
Mm-hmm.
But you know what? I'm not going to say I can't. I just need my man to lead me the right way.
Exactly.
And I'm so afraid that they're going to stray and they're going to try to lead me on the wrong path. So I got to step up. I got to be like, look, let's go this way. You might say, let's go this way, but I got to say, uh-uh, we can't do that. We got to go this way. So,
but that's okay.
You can't expect it.
That is your job as the queen to make sure when you sit back and you look at your man, be like, okay, this path that you're going down, I'm not happy with this. So I'm going to be over here until you get your gatherings together and then you can rejoin us.
But see, they don't like that. Like,
they
need to be in control of everything. And
they don't like that from alpha females. And you and I are alpha females. Khalif has told me, he says, you're too vocal for me sometimes.
Mm.
I just want you to say, okay, Khalif, sure, Khalif. And you don't do that. And I've learned over the years that this is my woman and this is the type of woman I have.
Mm.
And it's very much of a challenge for him to step down. And I even had to tell him, like, you don't know how to let me be the queen I need to be, because you always feel as though you need to be overpowering me.
And you don't know how to let him be the man that he needs to be. And that's the problem. They don't like feeling that way. They need to feel like the man all the time.
They do. They do need to feel like the man all the time. You're right. And I'm working on that, and I've gotten.
But I mean, is that, you find that a problem? I mean, really, I don't find it a problem. Like,
what?
If you doing what's right.
For him to be the man?
No. I don't feel like it's a problem for you to try to run things if he not doing right.
Oh, yeah. I totally agree. I do feel as though it is a woman's responsibility to step up when the mm-hmm. time is right. Let your man be, I know you don't like the word submissive, but I'm totally okay with you being my king and being submissive. But that doesn't mean that I'm going to allow you to disrespect me or treat me any type of way. Right. I think we take the word submissive and it just goes,
yes.
I was trying to use that as a perspective point of view. Mm-hmm. We're each hearing it differently and we have a different perspective on it. There are certain people that I will never submit to any man, but it's because of how they're visualizing it.
Yeah, and I don't think they really mean it. Because I used to be like, oh, I ain't submitting to nobody. Uh-uh, I ain't doing none of that. But if that guy, if he is leading you the right way, mm-hmm. you can't help but to.
You
like,
you're going to follow. You're going
like,
to follow.
We have this, I think we have this strong facade up because we're used to handling our business. We're used to doing everything for ourselves. And then when a man comes into our life and tries to change things and we don't feel like something, we feel like something isn't right there or like they're not doing the right thing and we talk to them and try to get them on the right path and they ain't doing, we're just like, oh no, we gotta step up. Yep. We gotta do this. We gotta mm-hmm. do that. And you know what? I feel like I'm okay with that. But I know I can kind of tone it down a bit. And sometimes I do try, yes, you're right, but it sounds so phony. It sounds so phony. I mean, I try it, but it sounds so fake. But I try to avoid the fight. I try to avoid the argument by kind of just making him feel like, okay, yeah, you the man, uh-huh, whatever. But it don't always work because he knows how I am. And he knows that I don't really believe it. But all I need him to do is just get on the right path, lead me in the right direction. Mm-hmm. And I'm cool. I could just like sit back and just chill and let you lead. Go ahead. Do what you want to do, boo. Whatever.
So do you see marriage in your relationship?
In this current relationship, and I'm going to use my age, because of my age, I don't really see myself being with anybody else.
Because you're scared to date?
I think I'm scared of dating too. That's part of it. I'm scared to date because I'm not sure what's out there now. Dating seems so hard. I'm like, where do you even meet people at? Where do people meet people? Like, is it online? Do you meet people in a grocery store?
I think it's
store?
Online because where do we go? I know I don't go nowhere.
Oh, so. Yeah, that's another thing. I don't go nowhere. I don't do nothing. Like, how am I going to meet somebody? I'm not meeting nobody. Yeah. I got girlfriends that's like really single. And they tell me that they having Zoom dates and they're on Black People Meet and all these yeah. different websites. And I'm like, well, how do you feel about like going out with these people? And then they have such bad stories when they do meet the people. And then when they do start talking to the people more often, they have these bad stories. So I'm like, okay, maybe I just need to chill where I'm at because I know what to expect. But I know we're not supposed to become complacent and just say, okay, I'm gonna be with this person just because I don't know what else is out there.
Well, I never, okay. So there's two parts to this. I do feel genuinely whoever you are with, regardless married or not, you should be happy to be with that person. You should have genuine love for that person. And I'll use myself as an example. Khalif and I may not be legally married. We've been together for what, 23 years now? Something like that. But I love this man. I really do love him. Even through the hard times and all the bullshit that we've been to, Keisha, I really do love him. And I'm, you know, we have our days. And sometimes I, not to put all the burden on him, I also have to check myself, my attitude and how I come some days. Mm-hmm. So I don't feel as anybody in their relationships should be complacent because if there's a void that is missing, it could lead to things like why people cheat, why you stray emotionally, yep. because there's a detachment in the relationship. So I guess complacent, that word, when it's a relationship, I don't feel you should ever be so complacent. You know, it's just, that's not a good thing. Everything should connect. Right. Both emotionally, sexually, and physically, everything should connect. If you're in a relationship with somebody that you barely want to sleep with, then to me, complacent, oh, that sex is an important thing in a relationship. Y'all not doing it. So what the heck? That's unhealthy.
But what's more important, communication or sex?
You need both, Keisha.
Yeah, you need both. But is one more important than the other?
They're both at 50-50.
Really?
I need sex.
Really? I don't need sex.
Listen, I'm not having kids. Oh my gosh. I am not having kids just to procreate. I mean, I'm not having sex just to procreate. You know, I mentioned that to you yesterday.
You did. But you know what? I don't know. Why? Okay, so I feel like I don't need sex like that. Mm-mm, I don't need sex. But okay. I do need communication.
So this is another interview I need to have you on because we're going to stray into a whole nother topic, okay? So we're going to stay on point here, but this is another. We need to bring our guest back on because she's talking about she don't need sex. We'll have another discussion about that.
I mean, don't you got toys and stuff? Like, when you got toys. And even with the toys, I don't use the toys. But I know.
But we got to participate with that.
Oh, no. He's not in.
We'll have
we're having that.
Our guests will have to come on again, and we're gonna have to bring that topic up. But as we wrap up today's topic, I wanted to ask you, what advice do you have to get, since we are mature women, you know, who have years of relationship experience, however you want to see it? I feel like life is what we make it, and you know, and many times as adults, I always say we have more control than we play we do, you know. Because we call each other all the time and I tell you, oh, Khalifa's making me so mad today, girl. You know, so, it's just part of life. But genuinely, I love that man, you know, and he might make me mad today, but then like he brings me a ice cream Snicker bar in the morning and that made me happy.
Oh! Ice cream Snicker bar in the morning.
Yeah, he got off of work this morning and he brought me an ice cream Snicker bar. It's little things like that that, you know, your partner does that really brightens up your day. But what advice do you have to give for a younger woman who's just starting life? Prime example, your daughter, Kalia, as she matures. Your daughter, Sierra.
Our daughters.
What advice do you have to offer these girls as they enter into the world? The world is lethal.
Well, I want them to know that it is okay to be an alpha female. And if a guy thinks of it differently, then that's not a guy you need to be with. I also want them to take their time and find the right partner. Like, don't just jump into these relationships because your friend is in a relationship. Jump into a relationship when you know that this is the person that you want to be with. Take time to get to know that person. You don't have to get married at 20. You don't have to get married at 25. You can get married at 30, 40. You can get married whenever you want. But take your time. Make sure that that's the one, because you don't want to go through a divorce. I know it's not expected. But there's always red flags in relationships. If you see a red flag, move on. If you don't want to work it out, if he doesn't want to do better, move on. Don't stay in a relationship that isn't healthy. If that person doesn't make you happy, then there's no need in being with them. And it's like, when you're young, it's so much easier just to leave. But as you get older, it doesn't seem that easy anymore. Because then you have kids involved. You have families. Oh, you become attached to things. It's just hard. So just be careful.
Wonderful. So as we wrap up part one today, you guys are going to, I'm going to keep you on the edge of your seats as we continue part two of the discussion next week. And we're going to go into another few series of questions. So until next time, just stay tuned for part two. Thanks for tuning in to Femme Palais Podcast. If you want to continue the conversation or share your takeaways, I want to hear from you. Head on over to the website or join our Facebook community and comment your favorite part of the show or share your thoughts. I want to hear what you have to say. Don't forget to rate and subscribe to the podcast so you never miss an episode. Chat with you next week.